that you can't hide.
He won a record 3 Defensive Player of the Year awards back in his day. He was also the league MVP in 1986.
One of two defensive players who won the MVP award in the NFL. The second one, Alan Page with the Minnesota Vikings, the linchpin of their Purple People Eaters defense.
On 2nd and 11 now, Wilson. Buying time to his left. They give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
First down, yardage to the 35. 2 yards and able to get the first down in the process.
So right after the defense gets you the ball on a takeaway and a fumble recovery of their own, you've got to reward them, don't you? You've got to stay out on the field, give them a chance to rest, and how about doing it the way they did it, running the football and picking it up on third down.
Yeah, would not have wanted to go 3 and out. They avoid that right there.
Yeah, they avoided the glares as they went back to the bench, didn't they?
Get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. We're scoreless after 1. 2nd quarter now, Falcon football, as they've got it with a 2nd down and 2 coming up. Taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league. Trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Push him back. Push him back. Kill, kill, kill.
On 2nd down now, Barkley.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
On 3rd down, Barkley. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Got what he needed for the first down with a gain of 2.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4 down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 14 yards there and a Falcon first down.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success. How about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. 14 yard line.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Let's go, D.
Second down, Barkley. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Not too many more ideal situations in second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They keep it with Barkley on first down, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. The linebacker, C.J. Mosley, in on the stop. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain. First at about the 9 yard line. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now Zane Gonzalez for the field goal try. This is a 26 yard attempt. Gonzalez's kick is good. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. That will go down as a 15-play drive, and it results in 3 points. So some disappointment?
It's funny. We had our conference before the game with the offensive coordinator. And what did he tell us? I just want every drive to end in a kick, right? An extra point, a punt, or a field goal. Well, in this case, I think it is a little bit of a disappointment because it did end in a kick, but that type of a drive should end in the end zone.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity. At the 28-yard line.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight.
I'm going to run you over.
Hey, watch that, watch that. Check Mike 54. Mike 54. And let's get that.
Jackson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Lawrence Taylor. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. Now after that sack, it's third and long for Jackson and the Ravens.
What we got? 54 is Mike. 54 is Mike. Check, check. Watch. Go, go. 54.
We ain't giving him nothing to do.
Here's Jackson on third and long. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Lawrence Taylor able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Play of the half here. It's Jackson. He's going to launch this thing way down, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Champ Bailey. And he will be brought down. His time is now run out on this first half of action. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. The The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway.
Come on now. Let's go.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe making a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
Play out, play out, play out, play out.
This time, Wilson will throw. That one caught by Tyreek Hill.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. Now here's Michael Dixon, and surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Ravens will get it. First and 10 from deep in their own territory. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Check tight.
Again, they'll run it with Mostert. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. That one good for 13 and a Raven first down.
Watch twist. Show me.
Now Mostert. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 10 yards there. Good enough for a Raven first down. A CD a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15.
Hey, what's that? What's that? Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
It's been a long day for you.
25. Check 25.
Check 3.
Check 3. Check 52. Under.
Cut up.
They'll run it now out of the gun. A good comeback there after the penalty. 9 yards, and it's second and 6.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Right there, 54, right there, 54, Mike.
All day, just like that,
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he loses the football a second time. And the Falcons say they have it. They do. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. He didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
They'll try and get this run game going. This is Barkley. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he gets it down to the 32. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
You ain't going nowhere.
Go, go, go.
Motion. A first down carry for Barkley. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized.
Hey, come on out here. Don't get I'm still double count right here. Double count. Here, what? No, no, no.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. This is Barkley. He's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and they're going to face a third down. Here's Wilson. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The perennial Pro Bowler Aaron Donald gets the sack.
Now that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down.
Let's go.
Yeah. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
I tell you what, it's kind of hard to imagine. They have not scored a single point, and yet they're in this position. A touchdown drive here, and they're in the lead.
Normally, when you have zero on your side of the ledger on the scoreboard.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. 77 yards as his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead here in the fourth. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And they have taken the lead here in this fourth quarter. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line.
Let's go! Let's do it!
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Boy, nowhere to go at all on that first down run as they will get to him behind the line of scrimmage. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a second and 11. They'll run it again with Barkley. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Brings up second and 9 at the 31-yard line.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. And some room to maneuver. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Tyreek Hill, 69 yards. And the Falcons have retaken the lead. So a big play coming for the Falcons as they'll go for 2. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And he is not going to make it. So they won't be able to move this lead up to a touchdown as it'll remain a 5-point ball game. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This will be taken short. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
So Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. And again, this time to the tailback. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Short gain, last two plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense are saying go right ahead with those. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Figuring they're going for it on fourth down. Remember, though, they do have all three timeouts, so even if they don't get it, all is not lost.
Yeah, normally in this situation, when you're talking about having to go for it, everything is in this play. But as you noted, with those three timeouts, they actually have a little bit of a safety net.
And down by five, they've got to go for it here on fourth down. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
They'll try and throw for it with Jackson. Man open. It's Moss complete. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first. They got exactly what they wanted there. Out route, catch, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
And I have to criticize defense here, because you know the situation. You want to keep them in bounds and have the clock run. So I'm sitting on the outside portion of the field and not letting them throw an out route. Throw anything inside and I'll make the tackle. An out route? That's not the way you're supposed to play it.
Give them a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
You can't block me. You can't block me. You can't block me.
He's back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and he can't corral it. That would have wrapped it up if he'd been able to hold on. Instead, it brings up third down. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and in the second quarter, he may very well run by him, but in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football.
And they just have to make it stand up one more time, because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
He's coming. Double up, double up. He's coming, double up.
They're going on fourth down. It's Jackson. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Brian Dawkins, the safety, with a pick. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
Yards on the scamper there.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason.
Oh no, he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Ravens, and his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Got a man, it's Randy Moss, complete. Now the Ravens gonna use one of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Steps away to his left. He'll try and run it. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down. One last shot. shot for Jackson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before... With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Atlanta. This will be taken very short. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Maybe a yard up to the 29. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
It outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight.
It's now third and eight.
Now, with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight.
Hey, watch the ball, watch the ball.
Watch quick. Watch.
19.
Tempo.
Now this time he'll look to throw. into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Deion Sanders, the former Falcon, with it. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. It's a gain of 5, and it'll bring up a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And always spins past him and into space. 30, 10, touchdown, Carolina. Gale Sayers, 52 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken short. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive.
Tackles, tackles.
Shift, shift.
Six to six. Pull it half. Check, check, check.
Touch 50, touch 50.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Throw right side is hauled in by the tight end, Gonzalez. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down. Maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play, as we'll get a timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game.
Four down,
19.
Whip. Watch the whip.
Just that.
From the gun, it's Wilson. He'll rifle this one deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Tyreek Hill, 77 yards, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be at practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This will be taken very short. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here we go, here we go. 120!
A run at Sayers' right side, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Now, Wentz, I think this is going to be a free play. Oh, this is intercepted, intended for Hill. Picked off by the former USC man, Taylor Mays. And they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. And the penalty helps, but not a whole lot. It's still third and long. From the gun, it's Wentz. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a Panthers first down, 17 yards on the play.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Right through.
Looking to throw on second down. Wentz. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Champ Bailey. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They'll run on first down. Barkley. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about 3 down to the 38.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Move the team!
On second down now, Barkley. And yeah, nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
No gain on the play. Brings up third down and seven.
They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first. This is third down. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They'll need to get it to the 30 for a first.
Got it.
This is third down.
25.
Right, check. 59.
Hey, zero. Good guys, four down.
They snap it at one. Now Wilson. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
Gonzalez on for the field goal. A 55-yard attempt.
And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you've got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. They run with Sayers. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. A run. This is Sayers. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple. Two minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score. Fans, a reminder. I have a note card here that says ad-lib halftime previews. So I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
But, you know.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked up by Champ Bailey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And fortunate to get points on the board last night. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. On second down, Barkley. And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick, and shifty. Can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. And that led to a really nice game.
Throwing is Wilson. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Well, switching gears, CD, I got to tell you, it's always sad now that football's over. We've got a long wait until Thursday,
look
September 10th.
It's okay.
I know,
it's
but okay. September
you get
10th.
A little misty there.
That's when the 101st season starts. We just finished off season 100. I don't know. What are we going to do till then?
Well, I'm going to rest and relax a little bit, and so are you, but you're exactly right. It won't take us long to start to say, okay, when does camp start? How about OTAs, mini camps? We'll follow the draft. We'll do all the football things, but there'll be nothing like.
And got his man complete. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Russell Wilson with two first-half touchdown passes. And the Falcons push further out in front. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
This will be taken short. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Now Wentz. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And that takes us from second to third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Shotgun now for Wentz. This one caught by Terrell Owens. And he's going to be brought down short of the first at about the 31-yard line. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They do go for it. It's Wentz. Flush to his right. He is going to find Hill here. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Fight! 3-15! 3-15!
Under 10! Under 10! 10! Well, throw on first down with Wilson. Got a man. It's Randy Moss. And down inside the 15 he goes. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Atlanta. Barkley. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 4 yards there, and that should be the final play of this first half. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Now Wilson. And he's going to go down. So they pass up the field goal attempt to go for six, but as a result, they leave points on the field, and that's going to do it for this first half. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken very short. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Again, they'll run with Sayers. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Now Sayers. And he gets it down to the 32. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Solid.
He's coming.
You draw perfect.
On first down, Westbrook. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Check. Walk 54. Pick me up.
Here we go.
Watch the great 57. Kill.
From the 29, Wentz, it's Hill, complete. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option.
His struggles finding open receivers continue. I don't know the last time I saw him this inconsistent throwing the football.
It would be hard to find a date when he was this inconsistent. You know, in his locker, he keeps the word poise printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. He needs to find that poise right now.
He certainly does. In fact, I would suggest he lamping it.
And the ball is knocked out, and the Falcons grab it. And he's into the clear. The 40, the 30. 10, and he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that. That's what they've done all game long.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This will be taken short. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line.
At their own 26-yard line.